Hello, today I'm going to show you a setup using the town series of the Sylvanian families. Now my passion lies with the more traditional village-oriented Sylvanian families' homes and buildings, but I do love the town series as well because they just chose really nice muted pastel colors and the European architecture is absolutely stunning. So I combined this ornate, elegant town manor building with the blooming flower shop, the creamy gelato shop, the designer studio, and the fashion boutique to create this beautiful complex of buildings that is for rent in a splendid town by the sea. Now, Lunette the Midnight Cat is a single entrepreneur who's looking for a home as well as a setting for a fashion boutique. So the real estate mouse shows Lunette all of the buildings available and asks, which one do you like? And Lunette says, I'll buy them all. So let's see what Lunette did with the entire complex of buildings. We'll start with the first floor. Oh, there we have a lovely roll-top writing desk where she could write out all her bills and her letters. And above that, a gilded gold mirror and all of those moldings, so ornate on the walls that Lunette just absolutely fell in love with when she saw this building. Now her customers can come right in and see tables of all of her shoes and jewelry. Oh, lovely hats with floral detail, pocketbooks, all for sale and imported from Europe. And look at that lovely stole. Lunette is well known for her fine taste. On the second floor, we have a wonderful library. Lunette likes to spend a lot of her time here reading the classics, and her customers can spend time here as well. She has a nice fruit bowl set out and a vase of flowers with a really comfy leather chair to sit back in. And those are French double doors leading out to the balcony. And Lunette's cherished collection of classic literature and history, and her cat Charisma, which is actually a Playmobil figure lapping up some milk over there, but fits in wonderfully with the Sylvanian families. And then up here, you could see the really high ceiling with a wonderful chandelier, and look at all that detail, the molding on the ceiling. Oh, Lunette is so lucky. And Lunette fell in love with this view from the balcony of the rolling hills beyond the sea. Next, we have another section of Lunette's boutique. And here she has some sweets laid out for her customers, some macarons and chocolates, because such delicacies are expected in such a high-end boutique. Lunette stocks a lovely collection of pocketbooks and headbands. And these white shoes with the black floral detail were just imported from Paris. She's so excited about them, with that black and white polka dot dress to match, that elegant blue hat. Oh, what lovely items. Once the word gets out that Lunette has opened shop, she'll be the talk of the town. On the second floor, Lunette has her own dining room where she can entertain her guests. The table is already set for dinner with a refreshing salad to start, and all of her guests will be so impressed and entertained by this amazing view from the window of all the steamboats on the sea. Lunette has such an artistic eye for detail and the wow factor, and she picked the perfect complex of buildings to live in and to have her store. From the window view, her guests will be able to see all of the men working hard on the pier, the steamboats coming into dock, the lovely homes in the background. What a wonderful place for Lunette to entertain. On the rooftop, she has a party table set and important business associates waiting to meet with her. They're dressed quite fancily and ready to talk about the latest fashions. On the first floor of the next building, we have Lunette's personal kitchen, all spread out for her afternoon tea, some fresh croissants on the table, a lovely lavender tea set that Lunette picked up on her last trip to Paris. And Lunette is no stranger to the kitchen. She has just made her grandmother's best apple pie recipe, Oh, it smells so heavenly. On the second floor, we have Lunette's bedroom with a lovely floral pattern duvet. And her suitcase back there still needs to be packed because Lunette is a jet setter and leaving tomorrow for another business trip to Europe. And here in this corner, we have the absolute selling point for Lunette when she purchased this building. She knew this room had to be her bedroom with this angled window and its magnificent view of the sea. She enjoys the sunrise and a refreshing breeze as she gets herself ready for the day. And Lunette was so captivated by this fox wall hanging when she first saw it in Italy and brought it back with her. This lovely bedroom would be a haven for just about anyone. This enchanting view is like being in Europe all of the time. And the crowning glory is a little greenery and flowers at the top, which is a must for Lunette. Her hard work, dedication, and success has indeed created a paradise for Lunette to share with her guests.